to check in with my friend Congressman Chris Smith, who is one of the leading voices talking about something that many people in New Jersey have to deal with, and that is Lyme disease. You know, everybody has that concern in New Jersey that when the warm weather comes, out come the ticks, and they're on your dog and everything else. And this idea and the potential of getting Lyme disease and the strange lack of attention to it with medical resources from Washington is bizarre. And I'll just share with you a quick stat. There are about 300,000 cases of Lyme disease in the U.S. The number for the high incidence where it's happening more, it's up 300% in the Northeast. So this is a problem that has gotten exponentially worse over the past few years. And Congressman Smith is doing something about it. Good morning, Congressman. Welcome back.
Thanks so much, Bill. And thanks for having me on this morning.
So you had an event last night. Is that right?
Oh, we had a town meeting. I chaired a town meeting, had a town meeting in Wall Township. And we had three tremendous leaders. Dr. Benjamin Beard, who's the top guy from the Centers for Disease Control. Richard Horowitz, who is an internist who has treated 13,000 Lyme patients, and then Pat Smith, who is from our own congressional district, who is the president of Lyme Disease Association. And she's the one back in 1992, Bill, that got me involved in this issue. She came to one of my town meetings, interestingly, we had one last night, and said, "What are you doing? Will you help us?" And I arranged all these meetings with the top people at NIH, CDC, and was shocked and dismayed by their dismissive attitude, saying that chronic Lyme doesn't exist. Well, that has persisted almost to this day. We did get a major, major report. I worked on it since 1998, the Tick-Borne Disease Working Group, and it has affirmed everything we've been saying. You mentioned the 300,000 new cases every year, and the high-end estimate is even higher than that, believe it or not.
That's what's reported and diagnosed, and I have just through my own travels have realized there are a lot of people that go undiagnosed, and it's misdiagnosed as something else.
It's fibromyalgia, it's chronic fatigue syndrome.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, the ticks, and it's not just the deer tick, but all the other ticks, they often contain a mixture of all these horrific diseases and pathogens. CDC says now there are at least 18 pathogens and more are being created as they morph and evolve into other sicknesses. Plus, we have this explosion, as you indicated, of ticks on the soccer field, in our backyards.
Yeah.
We need to do tick checks every single time we're out. Make sure that your lawn is treated because it's everywhere. And it is really, it's shocking. It is the most, it's the leading infectious disease in terms of growth.
That's amazing.
And it gets the least amount of federal funds at the NIH and CDC. And I have been trying. I have a major bill that has been blocked over and over again. I have it again reintroduced in January. And it would, again, create a national strategy so that we could really go after this aggressively and effectively.
Chris, let me ask you, now that the Democrats have the majority in the House, and and certainly an overwhelming majority in New Jersey in terms of the delegation, are your colleagues on the other side of the aisle appreciative of this fight and understanding that it's their constituents as well? I mean, Jersey is just ripe for this.
Well, the interesting thing is, Bill, both parties have blocked my bills over the years, and the reason is the money.
Yeah.
The insurance companies have poured so much money into campaign coffers of individuals to block legislation like mine, because, again, a national strategy, it is almost like the orphan disease out there, because the insurance companies would have to pick up the tab of very aggressive, particularly for chronic Lyme patients, and that's about 10 to 20% of all people who get Lyme disease.
Chris, to be fair, the insurance companies just aren't making enough money. I mean, I totally understand.
Right.
It's unbelievable.
It is unbelievable, and I think it's scandalous.
Yeah, I do too.
Oh, maybe they made a mistake. You know, there was the Infectious Disease Society of America, or the people on the panel that makes up the definition of diseases. Everybody on the panel had conflicts of interest, so much so that the Attorney General from Connecticut some years ago was almost ready to prosecute. They said, "Oh, we'll amend our ways, nothing, like that has happened.
Yeah.
So, again, we're trying to push this as never before. My bill is bipartisan. Colin Peterson and I from Eastern Minnesota, I introduced it. He's the chief co-sponsor. We co-chair the Lyme caucus in the House, and we're pushing to say enough is enough.
Yeah.
You know, Zika and other things get money as they should, but $12 million for the season, and that's it.
Right. It's nuts. Well, listen, Congressman, I got to jump. I'm going to talk to you later today on Chasing News on Fox TV. We're going to talk about this issue. I'm going to keep this in front and center. And, you know, I appreciate everything that you do. I think you are absolutely one of the most outstanding constituent-based leaders in Washington. So the folks that live in your district are very, very fortunate to have you representing them.
And, again, we want to protect it. Half of all the new cases are children, too.
They're kids,
they're out on the
right?
Field playing baseball,
yeah.
And we got to make sure, or some other sport, or just having fun in the park. Tick checks are important. One of the things the CDC says is that after you've been out, in your grass or whatever, shower within 2 hours or less.
Yeah,
doesn't guarantee, but then do a tick check. But this is
check your kids,
I think, epidemic.
Right? Yeah.